Okay, everybody, the president is about to arrive. When he does, we're on him. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Okay, so the U.S. president, played by William Hurt, is about to make a big speech at a counterterrorism summit being held in Salamanca, Spain. Secret Service man Dennis Quaid, who already took a bullet for the president last year, spies something, a curtain fluttering in a window in a room in a building where no one is supposed to be lurking. His partner, Matthew Fox, runs to check it out. Bang, shots ring out, president down, chaos. Then a bomb goes off somewhere in the distance, and then another bomb goes off right in the middle of the panicky crowd. That's what we see in the first few minutes of the new thriller Vantage Point. Then, zwoop, we get this flashback. Number one, taking us back to the same starting point, high noon, just before the president's speech. Only this time, we follow a different set of characters related somehow to the vast conspiracy underneath the assassination attempt.
Mr. President, the chiefs have a satellite lock on their village. They're ready, they're waiting.
Ted?
Well, there's an issue of when we can go.
We go now.
You can't give the order. You've been shot.
Then, zip, again, high noon. Another character, then another, and after a while, you expect to hear Sonny and Cher singing I Got You, Babe, the way they did every time Bill Murray woke up in Groundhog Day. I have to say, Vantage Point is more work than fun. The plot, and the movie is all plot, plus some good actors, doesn't come together in surprising ways. And if it weren't for the climactic car chase, a good one, I feel like we'd still be hacking our way through the 17th flashback to figure it all out. By the end, I felt as if I were stuck in a game of Clue that got mixed up with a showing of Babel, intercut with a revival of the old 70s thriller Two Minute Warning. Not a good film. But the car chase in Vantage Point is entertaining, and for that, I give it 2 stars. For the Chicago Tribune, I'm Michael Phillips.